I am also a faculty member in an institute in Kolkata, but I am involved in this legal matters for people who are victims of state repression. So I had also come over here when the students of the Ambedkar Student Association, including Rohit and all, they were here. I was here in your campus at that time. And then this thing, after it happened day before yesterday, I came today morning. So basically, the legal situation is that there are three FIRs, okay, three first information reports which have been filed. One is by the police, the other is by the registrar of the university, okay? So these are two cases, one is 113 and the other is 114. And the police have also revived another FIR, which is case number 22, which was filed on the 9th of the death of Rohit Vemula. Okay, so there are these three FIRs. So under the first FIR, there are 30 students and two faculty members who are accused. In the second one, there are 45 accused. In total, there are 27 people who were detained. Okay? Then what happened is that the rule is that if you are detained by the police, then within 24 hours of the detention, the police has to produce you in front of a magistrate. And then the magistrate has to take a decision about your arrest. What happened over here, that did not happen. So there was a direct illegal move by the police. The police did not produce them in court throughout the day yesterday. What they did, like cowards, at 11:40 p.m., that is late at night, they produced 27 people in front of a magistrate. Okay? And the magistrate sent them for jail custody for 14 days. So that was the situation what we began with today morning. So today morning, there was a group of lawyers who were trying to file a writ of habeas corpus, which you normally file if a person has not been produced in the High Court. But when we found that these people had already been remanded to jail custody, the focus shifted to filing a bail petition. So a bail petition was filed for these 27 students. I have a list of them. Means, do you need to know their names?
Yeah.
Okay, yes. So the accused are M. Venkatesh. Mudavad Venkatesh. Mudavad Venkatesh. Then Donta Prashant. Then Lingaswamy. V. Lingas. Vikani Lingaswamy. Manne Krishank. Then Harish. Then Amruta Rao. Then there is Dr. Tathagata Sengupta from the Mathematics Department. Then Munsif. Then E. Ramesh. Then Tulasi Abhilash. Prasanna Vijay. Shubhadeep Kumar. Vaila Gautam, Mohammad Hasnujaman, Sriraj, Srirag, Deepak Sudevan, Tirthankar Chakravarti, Mohammad Shah, Avtar Singh, P. Adityan, Matthew Joseph, Rajat Thakur, Mohammad Ajmal, Ashik Mohammad, N. Subba Rao, Rishikesh Kumbhar, and K.Y. Ratnam, who is also a faculty. So two faculty members and the rest are the students who were sent to jail custody late last night, contravening all legal. Means I have a lot of experience of this legal, but I have never seen anything like that, that they were not even allowed to have a contact with the lawyers or the relatives, which is very much a part of the legal procedure which the police is supposed to follow. Then what happened today, the bail petition was filed, the bail petition was argued. There were many of the faculty members who were present, students were present, there were lawyers present. After the bail petition was argued, the magistrate said that I will give the judgment, decision after half an hour. But after half an hour, what she did was that she didn't give either a yes or no decision, but kept the judgment in abeyance till Monday. So the situation is, so this is a very sort of devious method, because it has been kept in abeyance, no further legal move can be done. So now we are basically stuck till Monday, and these 27 people will have to remain in jail at least till Monday, when this decision will be given. So this is the scenario. The public prosecutor who stood in on behalf of the state made many types of allegations, telling that the students are they have behaved like hardcore criminals, so they should be treated like hardcore criminals.
Same.
So this was the thing, and then they have said that this was a pre-planned sort of attack on the VC and on the residents of the VC. So this was sort of the argument which the was which the PP has given. So the arguments were weak because there were this doesn't follow any point of law. But what therefore the magistrate has done is to put the order in abeyance till Monday, which is 28th. So till then, these people will be remaining in jail custody. So that is the scenario. Pardon me, any questions here?
What is the guarantee that the magistrate will believe that?
There is no guarantee. There is no guarantee. It can be a negative judgment also. So that is also possible. So I will also tell the charges which have been put against them. The charges include 147, section 147, 324, 353, 332. Yeah, so these are things. So among this, most of this, so there are like charges like trespassing into another's residence. Then there are charges like illegal restrainment. That means you are restraining someone from doing something. So among all these charges, there are two charges which are non-bailable as such. One is section 147, which is injuring or attacking someone with weapons. So that is one of the charges. And the other is section 353, which is stopping a public servant from doing his or her duty. So these are the two non-bailable charges which have been put. And then there is also Destruction of Public Property Act. There is destruction of public property that has also been accused. So the police today, the PP said, the public process said, we don't have any evidence, we will give all the evidence on Monday.
They can create.
See, I don't think they can also give evidence. They are basically they got it postponed. They know that they cannot produce evidence, so they just got it postponed for this time.
Are they going to be safe?
In the jail custody, normally people are safe, but definitely people are not right in jail custody. Yeah, but it is different from police custody. Police custody, a person is liable to be beaten up, tortured, etc., which generally doesn't happen in jail custody.
Were they beaten up in the police custody?
There are reports that happened actually. That's especially while being carried from here in the police van, they must have been. So the thing is that no one till date has been able to meet any of them. That is the worst scenario. No one has been able to meet any of them.
Why cannot we file anything against the
faculty? Met some of them.
Yeah, but not in after jail, I think.
Not
in jail. When they were in the police
station. When
the police station.
So. Can the students file a case against the police brutality?
That is possible. So, especially I saw there was one student or someone who has been beaten very badly who is hospitalized.
Yesterday.
Manu. Yeah. Definitely, he can file a FIR. I also suggested to the friends here that FIR should be filed actually against the police. Yeah. So, people who have been beaten up, etc.
One by one.
So, you all can discuss with the lawyers. And can definitely file FIR.
And heard that one of the policemen was saying to one girl that he will rape,
Definitely FIRs can be filed.
But they are used vulgar language also they use.
Yeah, they can. So you all consult with the lawyers, and then if you all can, this can is definitely something which can be discussed.
We have heard there are many FIRs are filing at different police stations. Apart from
us. As far as we know, there are just these three FIRs. So I should tell there is a third FIR, which is this case 22 of 2016. This dates from this 18th January, I think. That is on the day of Rohit Vemula's institutional murder, or that is what we call it. Yeah, that day. So basically that day, apparently again, there was damage to public property. There was restraining of and stopping of public servants doing their duty. And there are three accused in that, which is basically, I think, this Mudavad Venkatesh, Donta Prashant, and this Linga Swami. So this is the FIR which they have revived now. Okay, so I think that is the...